music is an art form for me. So for me to call myself Davinci after a very serious artist kind of was a really natural thing for me to do.
This is the amount of effect. I'm not trying to set you up, Davinci. I'm not trying to set you up, right?
Alright, go on.
Can I be clear and concise?
Alright, please.
Go on. Yeah?
Hold on a cut and pick a minute here, yeah?
Good.
Not only do you come in 2 weeks and 6 minutes late.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
He's taking the main mic. He's taking your mic.
He's taking my mic.
And you're having that.
Okay. Can I just say for the record, though,
yeah.
I was downstairs with your visual guy
yeah.
doing an interview for the last 2.5 weeks. So I was here on time. Anyway, I forgive you. I do forgive you for that, because at the end of the day, like I said, you've got me out of some very tricky situations. I do forgive you for that. So
I had to work with Natsha Bedingfield at the moment. Really, really feeling her tone and her voice and her vibe. I reckon I could do something pretty special with her. Yeah, there are a few people, to be honest. There's so many, I think we'd be here for too long.
Birmingham, Sweden and Netherlands, because Invincible Radio as well, but I don't know who Davinci is. How did you start? I mean, you could have been a solicitor, you could have been a hairdresser, you could have been a doctor, you could have been a, you know what I mean?
Anything
you want to be. So what made you go into music and production first?
I've been doing music since I was a kid, I think, so it was just a natural progression to take it seriously, to be honest.
What were you inspired by?
Yeah, I mean, first off, as well, yeah. Because there's a lot of up-and-coming producers listening out there now. How did you actually, you know, start off? Did you start getting your equipment first, or did you do a program first? Did you study? What did you do?
I tell you what I did. I had a program. You know those little PC packs you get? No. I had one called Cakewalk. You know those little PC packs you get with loads of different programs?
Yeah.
Loads of them, you get them in a magazine, a PC magazine.
Yeah.
It was a production program in there called Cakewalk. And I was like, tinkering and messing about with that. Because I could play keys as well. I started kind of playing keys and knocking out beats. I was like, I could do this.
Yeah.
Just turned into what I am.
The album is full of collaborations, so it's all my production. Predominantly my songwriting. But a lot of it is also co-written with the artists that are featuring on the tracks. Like, I've gone really from the whole singer-songwriter direction to real dark underground grime roots as well, to quite happy grime roots as well. So it's really got a nice balance of pretty much everything that I do musically.
Now you've kept it clean, professional, which is a good thing.
At the BBC, didn't he? The classical concert.
Did you?
That's amazing.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, what did you perform there? What sort of
How did you know that? How did she know that?
I know.
Oh, okay.
What was that like? What genre of music did you
play there? It was called Urban Classic, so it was like urban versus classical.
Yeah.
What we did was scored the music for the BBC Concert Orchestra to kind of be the background music for loads of artists that came and performed, Bruiser and Purple.
Oh, Bruiser, he came in here, didn't he?